night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Echo in my soul. Oh, soul. Sing. In every season, you keep repeating promises to me.
Moms and dads, how are you doing today? Miss Erica here. We are gonna power up. Let me see your muscles. Power up today. And our lesson is talking about I will persevere. Everyone say that with me. I will persevere. Good job. Well, you may say, well, that's a fun word, Miss Erica, but I have no idea in the world what persevere means. Well, it means to not give up. Say that with me. Not give up. All right. Now, you may notice that I am wearing this medal. It's actually a race that I did not run. I'm just being honest here, but it is Fly with the Eagles. It's the 2021 half marathon, and my wonderful husband directs this race. Actually, he times this race, and he rents out the equipment. Now, he got this, and what does it say on it? It says 2021 finisher. How many of you like to persevere? You like to get it done. You like to finish. Let me see your hands raised. Yeah. We like to finish. How many of you, when you're taking a test, you want to finish and you want to be first? Oh, yeah. When you're running a race, you want to be what? First. That's right. So we're not going to give up. We are going to finish. We're going to persevere and know that no matter what, God is with us. Amen? So today we're talking just for a few minutes about a dude named Josiah. Everyone say Josiah. All right? Josiah was not, shake your head, no, he was not old. You know how old he was when he became king of Judah? Now, Judah was an area that included Jerusalem. Y'all have heard of Jerusalem, okay? Want to take a guess how old he was? Just shout it out. He was 8 years old. How many of you are eight watching this right now, okay? Or maybe you were eight or you're getting ready to be eight, yeah. Josiah was 8 years old when he became king, it tells us in 2 Kings chapter 22. He reigned for 31 years in Jerusalem. Now, here's the cool part. He did what was right in the Lord's sight and walked in all the ways of his ancestor. You know, the guy that came before him? The ancestor was David. Y'all know about King David? Yeah. He did not, shake your head, no, he did not turn to the right, okay? So, your right is my left. I want you to point to the right, and now I want you to point to your left, all right? He did not turn to the right or to the left. Well, what in the world does that mean? That means he stayed focused. Everyone say, I will focus. I will persevere. Good job. He did not give up. Now you say, well, that's great, Miss Erica. What in the world does that mean to me? Well, in this time, Josiah was king, and there was a lot of junk going on in Judah. That was not good. You see, the Lord was pretty ticked with what was happening in Judah leading up to Josiah's reign. They were worshiping false gods. They were doing all kinds of things that went against God's word at that time. Can you believe it? And the Lord was angry with the people. Now, he showed mercy upon Josiah, because remember I said he was 8 years old when he became king and he did what was right in the Lord's sight. He went in there and cleaned it up. Everyone say, I'm going to clean it up. Yeah, Josiah decided, I may be young, but you know what? I'm not too young to be used of the Lord. And I'm talking to you also, not too young to be used of the Lord, no matter what. And don't let anyone tell you that you can't do it with the Lord's help, because you can. Josiah proved it. He persevered. He did not give up. And he cleaned up Judah. And he got rid of all those false gods and all those idols and all of those things that the people were worshiping that was not pleasing to the Lord. And you know what? Even though the Lord definitely showed judgment upon Judah, he spared Josiah because Josiah was right in the Lord's eyes. So I challenge you today as we finish up, boys and girls, moms and dads too, do not give up. And I'm going to repeat this. 1 Timothy 6:11. This is the second part of verse 11. Pursue righteousness and a godly life, along with faith, love, perseverance, there's that word again, and gentleness. How many of you agree? I'm going to be like Josiah, and I am going to not give up. You can win that medal in this life. Don't give up. I'm praying for you. I hope you have a great week. Bye-bye.